want to start your graphic design journey, but you don't have access to Photoshop? Well, don't worry, because in this video, I'll show you three of the best free websites to get you started in creating awesome graphics. Let me show you these three designs. Do you know which one of them I designed in Photoshop? Well, if you want to find out, be sure to stick around to the end of this video and be sure to let me know if you guessed right. Now, the websites that we're going to be using today are Canva, Photopea, and Over by GoDaddy. And just a disclaimer, this is not a sponsored video. You guys are always asking me how you can get Photoshop, or you're always telling me that you don't have Photoshop, but you still want to create cool graphics. So I thought, why not make a video about the best free Photoshop alternatives? So let's go ahead and check out these websites. So here we are on Photopea, and it literally looks like Photoshop. It's literally an online version of Photoshop. The only thing I don't like is the ads over here, but I mean, it's free and that's just a small price to pay. I mean, they have to make money, right? And what I like about this cool feature about Photopea is right here, it says PSD templates, right? And you can also see the kind of files that you can open here, and it can actually open Photoshop files. So if somebody were to send you a file and ask you to edit something in that Photoshop file, and you don't have Photoshop on that particular computer or device, you can head over to photopea.com and open that Photoshop file. How cool is that? And I know you guys are familiar with me using Photoshop in my tutorials, and this looks exactly the same like Photoshop, right? I can go ahead to File and then New. And here I can choose a template, right? I can input my own sizes. And here they have different preset sizes, you know, for Facebook covers, Instagram squares, Twitter profile, Twitter header, all different built-in presets that you can just click and start editing. So if you don't know the size of a particular graphic that you want to make, most of them, if not all of them, are already built into all of these websites, right? And I can even go ahead and input my own custom dimensions and DPI right here. This is very, very cool. Now let's just go ahead and probably choose one of their templates, right? Let's go ahead and see what they have under Instagram. And maybe we just want like an Instagram square to just like do a cool, quick graphic. But let me see what they have under templates. I'm gonna go to File, Open More, PSD templates. These are the built-in templates that they have here on Photopea, right? Let's go under Instagram, and they have 21 templates here. That's a whole lot to get started with for a free website, right? This one looks cool. Let me try using this one. Do I just click it? Is that how it works? It looks like it. So I just clicked it and it opens here just like Photoshop, right? I have all my layers over here. I can turn them on and off. And I have a photo right here. I'm wondering if I can replace this with my photo. Let me go ahead and go to File and see what options I have. Open and place. This is the first time I'm using this, right? Here I have a folder of things that I want to use, and I know I want to use this photo of me here. All right, so let's see. See, that's very, very similar to Photoshop, right? I'm guessing if I pull one of these corners here, it will allow me to increase the size of the picture. How cool is this, guys? Like, seriously, how cool is this? This is literally a free website. All right, I probably need to change the text to black or some other color. Maybe let's use the Learn Share Orange. I'm guessing I just go over here to the color. Is that how it works? No. If I double click on it, I can change. Okay, I double click on the text and I can change the color up top. Let me change it to the Learn Share Orange. Is that it? That looks like the Learn Share Orange. How does that look? Let me move my photo down. Let's change this because I'm not necessarily running a sale. I'm just get creative, because we're talking about like Photoshop alternatives, right? Get creative for free, right? Let's see if I can change the color of this second text here. What do you guys think? That's pretty cool, right? Should I make the orange red instead? No, let me keep the learn share colors. What else do we have here? We have this text here. I just double click, change it to black. Do I want to use black? Yeah, let's use black. Let's see what we got. No Photoshop. Can that fit? No Photoshop. No problem. Is that too much? Problem. Alright, can I adjust this? Cool. Alright, cool. This is not too bad. Maybe size it down. Where can I find the character? Like, this is so similar to Photoshop, guys. Like, it's literally Photoshop online. Like, literally. Alright, let's put that there. Maybe let's bring this over up some more as well, right? I can bring out rulers too, right? How cool is that? How cool is that, guys? Like, seriously. Alright. And it's clicking. It's actually snapping to the rulers. This is so cool. Alright. Info. Alright, let's just change this to link in bio, because I'm gonna post this on my social media pages, right? So let's see what we have here. Change the color to white because it's on my shirt. Oh wait, change the color to white because it's on my shirt. All right, let's change the black button around the learn more to how do I change the color of this? Shape tool. Oh, it's actually the same shortcut to U. That is very interesting. But how do I select it? Is it not a shape? Is that not what it is? I guess not. Let me add a color overlay. See if that works. Yes, that works. Let's just pick. Well, the color picker is working. Cool. Guys, this is literally Photoshop. Like, literally. I've only ever heard of Photopea but actually using it now. This is literally Photoshop online. Like, literally. No, I don't like that. Let's make the learn orange or white, and then let's make the button or the rectangle blue. But I need to go over some more so I can see this blue. All right, that looks more like it. But let's wonder if I can group elements. Control and G. You think it's gonna work? Is it gonna work? Let's see. It groups just like Photoshop. All right, let's call this learn more. And I should be able to save this as a Photoshop file and then open it on my computer. That would be so cool, right? All right, I think I'm good. I think I'm good with this. What else would I want to do? Let me try and duplicate this photo layer. And let me just like give it an effect, like change the blend mode of this photo, right? And see what we can come up with here. Not bad, not bad. Just pretty standard stuff, similar to what you do in Photoshop. I mean, I would love to use the camera raw filter, but I'm not seeing that here. Saturation. How do I get, which one of them is the black and white one again? I cannot remember. But as you're seeing, like, I have so many options here, right? And you even have the history tab. You can see everything that you've done right here. This is so cool. All right, how do I change this though? Does this not have camera raw filter? Or am I wanting too much? I mean, it's pretty cool as is, right? I'm not even gonna make a fuss. Can I bring in the Learn Share logo? Can I do that? Let's see. Just, you know, for the purposes of bringing it in. Open and place. Let's see what we have here. All right, this is nice. Where am I gonna put this? Do I need it? Do you think it's gonna be like overcrowded? What do you guys think? Actually, let me just pick, seeing as though I have it here, let me just pick the correct orange from it, right? In the grid creative, let me just pick the correct orange. Cool. Let me pick the correct blue as well. Just because we can, because Photopea is so powerful, right? And let's change this blue as well. Where is it? Okay, here's our group. So cool. And then let's pick the blue. Color overlay. So cool. And let's just hide the Learn Share logo for now. I don't think we need that right now, right? What do you get? Oh, background layer is locked. That's cool. What do you guys think? Let me save this and see how it saves. File. Can't save it? Interesting. All right. File. Publish online. That's all I'm seeing here. I wonder why I can't save a PSD Photoshop file. Maybe I have to save the paid version. In the paid version? I don't know if they even have a paid version, but all right, let's see if we can save it. Or maybe I need to create an account. Maybe that's what's happening. I'm not sure. But let's go ahead and just save this as a JPEG. And then I want all the quality. And how do I zoom out? That looks fine, right? Let me save it. Will it ask me to save? Okay, cool. 005. Let's go. LSPV free Photoshop alternatives, and then this is what, Photopea, and that's our JPEG image. I really wanted to save the Photoshop file, but this is good enough. Let's move on to the next website. All right, so now we're on Canva. And I'm sure a lot of you may have heard about Canva, and this is going to be the very, very first time I'm using Canva. I've always known about it, but I've never, ever used it before. Like, never, right? I've always recommended it, but I've never used it. All right. So let's go ahead and create an Instagram post similar to what we just did using Photopea, right? And as you can see, it's the same thing. They have templates, they have elements that you can drag on, right? And you can start like from a blank canvas. You can start from scratch, you know, adding elements you want. You can upload images. Let's see if I can upload a photo of myself. Seems that I can, right? Do I just drag it? I'm assuming I just drag it. All right, cool. I like this. All right, let's see if these tools appear. And Canva has a pro version, right? I'm pretty sure that pro version gives you more features naturally. Let's go ahead and see what they have in their templates. Oh, they have some pretty cool templates here. And how these templates work is you just choose one and you can customize it with your own image, right? All right, let's go ahead and choose this one. All right, and now I'm guessing I just click on these elements and just edit them as I see fit. All right, cool, so I can work with that. All right, let me see if I can change this lady right here. How do I change her? Replace background, is that what I want? No, that's not what I want. How do I change this? Oh, is this what it, no, this is rotate. How do I change this lady? Okay, cool. What do I All right, so I want to use my photo where this lady is, right? How do I do that? Oh, okay, cool. So I just select it, like select her, and then like replace it with my own media. All right, cool. I can live with that. All right. And I just like size it up by holding a corner, right? As usual. And then I just double click again, I'm assuming. Cool, all right. Let me bring in the Learn Share logo so I can get the exact, the accurate colors, right? I should have like written down the hex codes, but I didn't. Wait, let me just replace this with the logo. So I just double click it and then I drag my own thing in, right? Is that how it works still? Ungroup elements to edit or move them individually. Okay, how do I ungroup? Right click ungroup. All right, cool. Let's drag in my logo and see if it works. Oh, it doesn't look like it's working. All right, can I delete this one? All right, cool, I can. And then I love these lines that are telling me when elements are aligned. That's really, really cool. Link in bio, because we can, right? And then let's change this to, what did we write earlier? We wrote get creative for free. Create awesome. Can I extend this text box? No, that's not what I want. I want it to extend. Can I not extend it? Maybe it's not. Create, I guess awesome is, the word awesome is too many characters. Create cool designs. All right, that works. Let's change the color of this. How do I do that? How do I pick? Can I pick? That's not what I want. Oh wait, look at this. These are all the color. Are these the colors that it's detecting in my photo and stuff? Because this exact color, these two exact colors here are from the Learn Share logo. Interesting, Canva detects colors in stuff that you upload. Note to self. All right, cool. I can live with that. I can work with that. The orange here is clashing with the orange on my shirt. Can I make my photo black and white? How would I do that? Effects, no. Filter, no. Adjust. All right, saturation. All the way down to 100. Contrast. It's fine. I can live with that. How do I change these lines to blue, to like the Learn Share blue? Are they grouped? Of course they're grouped. All right. All right, cool. We're getting somewhere. Canva doesn't seem to have, what do you call it? The rulers that we're used to in Photoshop, but it's fine. The elements are still snapping to each other, to align to each other, so I can live with that. All right, no Photoshop. No problem. All right, it's a pretty cool tagline. I should probably trademark that. Let's move this up some more. But I can't trademark Photoshop, can I? The word Photoshop? I don't think so. All right, let's see what we have here. How do I, this is cool. I actually really like this. Canva has a buzz. Canva has a vibe. All right, can I download? I don't expect I can download a Photoshop file. But I can download a PNG or a JPEG. All right, let's do PNG because it says high quality image, right? All right, let's download it and see what we got. It says it's downloading. All right, let's save it as LSPV. What did I save the last one as? I cannot remember. Okay, here it is. LSPV free Photoshop alternatives. And this is Canva. All right, save, share this design and save time, get your shareable link. Also, I can get a shareable link and share it with people to look at it. Cool. All right, that's not what I want right now, but thank you, Canva. And let's move on to our next website. And yes, I saved the best for last. Over. I have been using Over for years, even with LearnShare and the social media posts that I've made on my Instagram and Facebook page. You've probably seen these posts before. Every single one of them was made with Over. Even some of my stories that I share on LearnShare is made or are made with Over. A lot of them. So maybe I have a slight bias to Over, but I actually use Over very, very often, and I've always recommended it. I've recommended Over and Canva together every single time, and I really like the layers feature of Over. Canva doesn't really have that, or I haven't seen that yet. Maybe it does, but I really like Over for that. But Over, even though it has the layers that I like, it's still not as powerful in the layers compared to Photopea was like literally Photoshop online, but I really like Over. So let's go ahead and dive in, and we're gonna make a square post as per usual, and we're gonna see the templates they have. As usual, they have preset sizes that you can make for Instagram square, Instagram story, Instagram portrait, landscape, the works. You guys know the drill, right? So let's go ahead and hit template over here, and let's see what they got going on. All right. Ooh, this blue one is nice. And this blue one right here is saying that it's 940 pixels wide by 788 pixels high. But I don't necessarily want that, because I want my design to be a perfect square so that it fits seamlessly on Instagram, right? So let me just go ahead and just select my design. And then if I go over here to the right, I can see canvas size, right? I'm also a little bit more familiar with Over because I've used it so often, right? So I'm just going to go ahead and hit square. And you see it resized it for me, but because I resized it, this blue right here needs to be enlarged or just dragged down a bit, right? So it covers it like that. So are these white little swirly swirls. They need to be dragged down just like that. And the first thing I'm going to do is just like change this photo, right? Wait, cancel. I just click on it and I believe, yes, the arrows. And can I upload? Let me try and upload an image, right? Same photo, you know the drill. And then, ooh, it already popped in. I didn't have to do anything much. This is pretty cool. I like it already. I love it already. Slight bias to Over. Slight, ever so slight bias to Over. And then, that's good. Done. All right. I'm wanting this logo out because it's not mine. How do I, okay, replace? I normally used Over on my phone, so I'm not exactly 100% familiar with the desktop version. All right, let's import the LearnShare logo. Pretty cool, right? But I have a white version to the LearnShare logo. Let me bring that in, and then cool, but I want the colors from the, let me undo that control and Z, just like in Photoshop. But I want the colors, I want to change this blue to the learn share blue, and I can just pick here. Wait, how do I color this? Okay, can I pick a color? Okay, cool. So I just hit this little circle with the like drop in it, and it just picked a color for me, but that's not what I want, is it? Well, the little swirly swirls are now orange. I mean, that's a learn share color, so it's fine. And then let's make this bigger. And I want to change this blue to the learn share blue with the color dropper. That's exactly what I want. And let me change this as well. The dropper, or maybe let's make this orange, right? Color. And now that we have all the learn share colors in, I can just change the logo to the white learn share logo, right? Ooh, what did I just do? That was to replace this. Upload. Nice. I like over so much. All right. And then I'm not running a sale, so let's just write, can no Photoshop fit here? Yeah, let's size it down. No Photoshop, no problem. I don't like how that looks. Maybe I can size it down even some more. Let me see what this is. Get creative with just an internet connection. Is that too much text? I don't think so. This is a pretty cool tagline. What do you guys think? Are these all aligned? How do I align them? 1, 2, 1, 2. I'm just using shift and my arrow keys just as if you were in Photoshop, right? How do I change this text? Okay, text. And then let's just like size it down. Is it bold? How do I change it from bold? Okay. Maybe medium. Light. Is that even changing? Normal. Get creative with this internet connection. That's pretty cool. I like this. I like this. What do you guys think? Should I keep the all weekend long in white? Should I even keep this rectangle orange, seeing that orange is already there with the swirly swirls? No, I don't think so. Let me go blue. And that looks good. Do I make the photo of me black and white this time around? Maybe not. Maybe I'll keep the color. I like this. I really like this. Let's go ahead and export this. And I know Over has some really cool, what am I doing here? Some really cool photo filters. Let me go ahead and check them out. I know some of them are free, but some of them you have to pay for. I like how that looked. I like this one. This is really, really cool. That's one of the cool things I really like about Over, the filters. They have really, really cool filters. All right, I'm okay with this, I think. Let me go ahead and just export it before I do anything else. And it looks like it was automatically saved because it said all changes saved, right? That's the cool thing about Over. You don't have to like hit save, it's automatically saving. All right, let's name our file. We don't want it to be called Over Project. LSPV Free Photoshop Alternatives. And this is Over. All right. Show settings, JPEG or PNG. You want it PNG for the most quality. And let's go ahead and hit export, right? And it will ask us where you want to save our file, and we're saving it right here. All right. So here are all our files that we made today. What do you guys think? Which one is your favorite? Be sure to let me know in the comments below. And just because I love Over so much, let's go ahead and make a thumbnail for this YouTube video that you're watching. Well, by the time you're watching it, I'd have already made it, but let's go ahead and make a thumbnail for this video, right? Let's use that same photo, but for the template or for the preset size, I want it to say like YouTube thumbnail, right? Do they have that? I'm not seeing it here. Ooh, thumbnail right here. They have it. They do have it. And I tend to make my thumbnails like 1920 by 1080 instead of 1280 by 720. So let me just go ahead and change that. All right, let's bring in my photo, or let's see if they have a template. Let's see if they have like YouTube thumbnail templates. YouTube. What am I gonna call this video? This video is like, we're looking at three websites, right? Here's a 10. So we can use like a list. Oh, they have a 5. I can probably change this 5 to 3, right? What do you guys think? So this is our template. Let's change this 5 to 3. Oops, because this is like 3 free websites, right? Let's also see that yellow line that's running across there. It's telling me that my number 3 is aligned in the center, right? Let's name this, rename this text or edit this text 3 free Photoshop alternatives or options. Alternatives, yeah. Text. Over has a lot of cool text, like tons, so much cool text. I can speak to that personally because I've used it so often, right? And then let me see, it's kind of too spaced out vertically and horizontally, so let me just like reduce that. Oops. Not 0, maybe 100. 80 is fine. 80 looks decent. And I want to just like change this image of this girl here. And they also have like free stock images that you can use, right? Free like unsplash images here. And let's search for computer because we're on a computer. Let's see what options we have for computer. I like the ones with this pink here. I like this one. Cool. All right. And if I click on it like I am now, I can give it an effect. Maybe I want it blurred out so it's not like that strong in the background. You see, as I increase the slider, the image is just getting more blurred out, right? That's pretty cool. And I can also adjust the saturation of the image, you know, draining it out, making it black and white. Or I can just intensify the colors like really, really hot. But that's not what I want. maybe a little bit of desaturation and then like a little bit of warmth, right? Blur it some more. And let's change this yellow to white, maybe. What do you guys think? And then I can also bring in the Photoshop logo onto this design, right? So let's do that. Let's go to image here and let's upload something. And I think this one right here is the Photoshop logo. Wait, do I want the Photoshop logo or do I want the Canva, the Photopea, and the over logo? Let's do a version with, well, I'd say let's do two versions, but for the purposes of this tutorial, let's just do the one with all the other logos, right? Because those are the ones that we're highlighting. All right, let's load them. Can I load them all in? No, one at a time. That works too. All right, let's bring in the Canva. And then let's bring in the over. Can I make these edges round? I'm not sure. No, I'm not sure. Let's just do what we're doing and not mess it up, right? All right, let's make them as big as the Photoshop logo. Let's size it down. Let's size this down too. That looks about the same size, right? All right, now where would I put these logos? Free Photoshop alternatives. This needs to be in the center. And then maybe bring this up a bit. So I have Canva. Over and so I'm guessing I don't want the Photoshop logo. What do you guys think? I think the logos of what we actually looked at, like the Canva, the over and the Photopea, I think those make more sense. Let me know what you think in the comments. All right, let's move this over. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And then let's move it over directly underneath alternatives. Let's size it down a bit some more. Just move it over some. 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2. Let's make the number 3 a bit bigger. Just like this. See what we have. Let's enlarge this free thing here. Or is it okay? I think it's okay. Let's delete the Photoshop logo because we're definitely not using that this time. Right? And let's just align all of this to the center of the document. What do you guys think? Let me zoom out and see what it looks like. You know what? I think I may actually like it with just the Photoshop logo. But we're talking about Canva, over, and Photopea. So as much as I really want to put in the Photoshop logo, I really have to just stick to what makes sense, right? And I think I'm just going to stick to the actual icons of what we're actually looking at, right? Zoom out. I actually like this. Let me try changing this font. Or let me try matching the free to the... Well, this is the kind of font that I'm always using for the Learn Share thumbnails. So let's keep it on brand, right? And then... Let me right, my standard thumbnail thing, which is the LearnShare website link. That's in every thumbnail, like www.learnsharephotovideo.com. LearnSharePhotoVideo.com. And then let's size it down really, really small. Oh, LearnSharePhotoVide.com, right? And then let me adjust the spacing on the text. Not so much, maybe 10. And then make sure it's aligned to the center. All right, cool, that's aligned to the center. And then let me turn down the opacity. The reason why you may not notice the LearnSharePhotoVideo.com is because I always like turn it all the way down. It's almost invisible, right? All right, cool. That's pretty cool. I really like this. What do you guys think? Let's go ahead and save this or export this, and let's call it, where'd it go? Let's call it LSPV free Photoshop alternatives. I'm so excited. Can you tell? Thumbnail. All right. Or let's call it YouTube thumbnail. All right. Export. We already have the name, and let's go ahead and hit save. What do you guys think? Now, to answer my question earlier, which one of these designs did I make in Photoshop? And the answer is none of them. Absolutely none of them. All I used to make these designs are an internet connection and my computer. Canva and Over by GoDaddy can be used on your phone, but Photopea has to be used on a computer. But nevertheless, they're all great options to get started in your graphic designing journey. So, no Photoshop, no problem. Here's my question of the day to you. Have you been held back by not having Adobe Photoshop on your computer or on your phone? And with all of these cool free websites that we looked at today, how excited are you to get started in creating awesome content and stepping out as a graphic designer? Be sure to let me know in the comments below. Thank you so much for watching. Once again, my name is Cjam, and I will see you guys in the next video.